Okay, I've got a report here that's showing me revenue by different states, different categories, and by different manufacturers here on the right over time periods. And one of the things that I want to do is be able to focus on individual time periods to just look at the revenue across my different states and my different categories by each year. Now, obviously, if I start to use this filter on the left-hand side and select an individual year, I'll just get one set of dots in that chart on the right-hand side, and that's not really much use. So one of the things that I can do is actually say, hey, this slicer on the left-hand side shouldn't impact this time period chart over on the right. And I can control how the interactions flow from this visual to another one. The other thing here is that when I select one of the states, the rest of these charts get filtered, and you can see this bar chart underneath. There's very, very small slices that get highlighted underneath it. And it's actually very difficult to identify the mix between these different product categories for each state. So again, I could say, well, actually, rather than highlighting this chart underneath, when I select something in this map, I want to filter this chart underneath. Again, I'm changing the way the interactions flow from this visual to this visual. So I've got two different things that I want to turn on here or to adjust here. And to edit these visual interactions, up on the ribbon, I see there's this visual interactions group, and I've got an edit button. And I can change how, when I select one of the data points in a particular visual, the behavior and the interactions flow through to those others. So by turning it on, you see I now have a set of different icons available on each of the charts as I have them selected. So I've got this slicer selected at the moment, and I can see that it's currently filtering all of these other visuals. Now, the thing I wanted to do was to say this slicer shouldn't have any impact on this line chart at all. So I can choose this none interaction, and now those things don't interact with each other. So as I change the years, you can see my map and my bar chart get updated, but it has no impact on this line chart on the left-hand side, the right-hand side rather. Now, what I wanted to do between these two charts was say that anytime I select an item in the map, it should filter this chart underneath. So if I select the map, I can see that currently it's going to highlight the bar chart underneath and filter the line chart on the right. And you can see when I click one of the states, yep, the line chart's being filtered and I'm getting the highlights on the bars underneath. So what I wanted to do was change it so that actually it's going to filter this bar chart. It's as simple as selecting the icon that's relevant to me. And now when I pick a state, you'll see that whole chart gets filtered. You can see it really easily by checking what values are shown on this axis. As I select a state with a small revenue, that axis gets updated. The relative changes between these categories become much clearer now to see as I select from state to state what those changes are. And of course, the filters that I was applying year by year by selecting this slicer still apply, and that's still filtering both of these charts. So I can build some quite complex relationships and interactions between these charts by doing that. And I might want to use a few different things to help people understand you know, how these things are being impacted. So for example, I might draw a shape around these visuals that are just related to each other. So now it's clearer for somebody who's using this report to see, hey, this slicer is impacting these things, but it's not having an effect on this line chart over here. I can use some of those different shapes and different elements within my report to help show people how those interactions flow. So you can build some really, really complex reports that do exactly what you want and make sure that the data and the interactions flow between those visuals just how you want.